Alright, yes, I'm back. Now it's time for more trust. Still gonna do the same strategy, still gonna use Marigo, except that my moveset is a little bit different now. My moveset. Gonna show just the other screen. Yeah, small taunt, super fat minimize. I temporarily remove subsidy and put taunt because Moltres. Okay, before that, Moltres is like 50, fire flying type, pressure ability. Yes, the move flamethrower, ancient power, air slash, and the stupid annoying move called safeguard. That's why I'm banking taunt. So without any further ado, let's battle it, and hopefully we can catch it with a Pokeball. Let's go. So as always, just like Articuno, I'll speed up, weaken it, then I start throwing Pokeball. Let's go. So yeah, now it's Pokeball time. Thank you. Oh damn, that's triple shit right there. Now that's the safeguard right there, and can't use safeguard because of my taunt. Just need to cooperate here, man. It might just be worse than Articuno, to be honest. Sometimes I also having trouble catching Moltres also because I think it's so stubborn, literally. Honestly, to my opinion, I guess for legendary, but among the three, Moltres is the most stubborn one to me. That's how I feel, and the most annoying one because has safeguard lah, very annoying and stubborn that doesn't want to stay inside the ball. But I don't know why for my platinum one, if you guys remember, I caught it quite fast though, I don't know why. Maybe it's lucky. So yeah, I'm different than other people. I try to catch legendary gun with Pokeball. For platinum, I was able to catch all legendary gun with Pokeball except Arceus. That thing's a problem, yeah. That one I really have no choice on, so yeah. Yes! There we go. Not bad, just a little bit longer than Articuno. Not that bad. So yeah, next up is going to be Zapdos. Hopefully the last one is not going to be the toughest one. I heard people saying that normally if you catch a legendary gun, which is a tree, which there is a trio like the legendary birds, normally they say the last one is going to be the toughest one to catch, but we'll see how it goes. So let me get out of here and show you guys the stats and I'll end the video. So yeah. Oh great, Repel have to roll off. Actually, to be honest guys, now that I'm playing this game, is my platinum is not actually that over. I'll be doing some rematch lah of some of the trainers that I've been before. Like, how to say, Some trainers I can rematch them lah. Like those trainers, oh, they originally team up with you. Like there's one at Iron Island, the trainer with Lucario, and the other one at Eternal Forest with Chansey. And there's another one at Vitero at the right side of Vitero who use Arcanine. These three are the few trainers that you can rematch with them lah. Yeah. I also do the gym leaders. Once all that is done, I'll probably rematch the Elite Four. Then that's it for my Platinum. I'm not gonna bother. I know I can do the Frontier Brain thingy at the Battle Frontier, but I'm not gonna bother doing it because Hard Gold and Soul Silver, the Battle Frontier Brain is the same as the Platinum one. So yeah. So I'd rather do it on my Hard Gold version instead. So yeah. And my Motron. Whoa, okay. I get a pretty bad nature as you can see right here. Jolly Ninja very bad because no one uses, and I named it wrong. I will go change later. I can go to Golden Rock City and rename it. I name it wrong. Okay, never mind. It's Moltres and it doesn't matter. It's still Moltres. Really bad Ninja. Jolly Ninja really bad. No, because no one uses a physical attacker Moltres. So yeah, here are its stats and that's it. So yeah, I'll rename it later. So next up is gonna be Zapdos. So stay tuned for that. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Please give a thumbs up, like, comment, subscribe. Thanks for watching. This is EvilTower123 signing out.